Here at Cygnet Hospital Hexham, we have two wards catering for female service users. We have a 17-bed acute ward, and we also have a 10-bed female psychiatric intensive care ward, or a PICU. Cygnet Hospital Hexham is in quite a rural environment in Northumberland. However, Hexham is one of the bigger towns in Northumberland, and we have access to all of the usual amenities you will find in any local town.
The hospital site itself is just on the outskirts of Hexham, which is a market town, which benefits from local sports facilities, leisure centre, swimming pool, lots of amenities, shops, with a nice main street. It has an open air theatre, an abbey, restaurants, cafes, which service users should hopefully be able to access when as the treatment progresses and they become well enough to do so.
At Cygnet Hospital Hexham, we have well-appointed bedrooms that are modern and recently refurbished to a high standard. We also have a salon and a gymnasium. We have two separate dining rooms for individualised care. At Cygnet Hospital Hexham, we have a number of gardens, one for the acute ward. We have an enclosed garden for the psychiatric intensive care unit.
The referral criteria will be any acute mental illness. This ranges from psychosis to affective disorders, also known as mood disorders, and everything in between. One of the key elements that we will be looking to address is that notion of complexity or comorbidity. So that means that someone could present with a primary diagnosis across the range of acute mental illnesses, but also have other features as part of their difficulties, such as personality disorders or substance misuse. And it's that sense of complexity that we'll be looking to address in a complete way, not just looking at the acute problem, but looking at the whole patient and how we can really support that individual to re-find their path through life of their own choosing.
Overall, the aim of the hospital is to provide safety and security to service users who are at the most vulnerable, for the shortest possible time. The whole emphasis on treatment is to engage service users at the earliest opportunity and make them fully involved in the care processes and get them discharged at the earliest opportunity when they're willing to do so.
So at Cygnet Hospital, we have a psychiatrist, we have a psychologist, we have an OT, an occupational therapy team, we have senior nurses, staff nurses, and a whole range of experienced support workers. This is the essence of the treatment plan, how an individual engages with the environment and that whole MDT. That's where the treatment comes from, in essence. Yes, we'll be using psychiatric medications as well and other psychological strategies, but it's through that sense of engaging with the environment and with the team where we find that the therapeutics emerge from.
We have clients that come to us who have low motivation, who are really struggling to participate into groups or even struggling to socially communicate. And what we're doing is adapting and grading that activity. So they have very short goals to focus on. So it might be that for someone who is really struggling with depression or really struggling with their ability to engage into society, that might be a goal that they want to achieve. So within the goal setting within group, it might be that they come to a social skills group or they come to the chat cafe, and their goal within that hour is to just come in, sit for 5 minutes and say hi. And for someone to achieve that, that is massive, and that then increases engagement in activity. And I think occupational therapy is very unique in that they can do that and break goals down really specific and smart to someone, whereas sometimes other professionals are looking at the bigger picture.
Then this kind of environment is welcoming service users in who are very, very acutely unwell and seeing them move on a lot better in a very short period of time because of the intervention of the overarching multidisciplinary team. I think there's nothing more rewarding than seeing somebody be discharged, knowing that you've done something positive and beneficial.
I love people. I love working with people. The greatest joy that I get out of my job is finding that understanding in a collaborative sense, not the psychiatrist saying you have this, this is your diagnosis, but that shared sense of an understanding that enables that individual to refine that path through life of their own choosing. And we'll get a lot of success. And that's why I'm here as a psychiatrist, to find those successes.